When I was younger, I had no idea why I had to work longer and harder at things that were so easy for other people. Why spelling simple words were harder for me than they were for them. As I became older, I realized I have ADHD and dyslexia, that things were always going to be harder for me than they were for them. I would like to share with you how people similar to me, along with other people with learning disabilities, live, and how we can all help them to make our world a better place. Raise your hand if you know or have a learning disability. Keep your hands raised if you know about their struggle. Now put your hands down. Think of this. 1 in 7 people are affected by learning disabilities, and that 2.1 million school children have a learning disability in the U.S. Learning disabilities can sometimes be a gift or a curse. It can make you have a special gift that no one else in the world has, but it can make you have a struggle that no one has. At the present moment, the difference between me and you is that I process information differently due to my learning disability. When I took the test for ADHD, I had to recall which aliens matched from the other page. I didn't even know which were on the other page, so how was I going to know which were on this one from the other one? Soon after that, I found my gift was art. Art was something I didn't have to worry about. If I made mistakes, as I did in writing, I could just keep on going on, ignoring my mistakes. Still, every day, I'm constantly reminded of my disabilities. When I write, I always have to look at each word to see if it looks right. And when I was in third grade with my tutor, she asked me, "What are the vowels in English?" I didn't know. Maybe somewhere in my boggled mind, I'd eventually be able to find it, but at this time, I couldn't. When I have a test that involves spelling, I immediately start studying because I know if I don't, I'll fail. Having a learning disability can be challenging. Reading for dyslexic people is a big challenge, and spelling for people who have dyslexia is a big challenge also. This is something that's not curable, so you have to learn to overcome your disability. You will always have to work 3 times harder at things than normal people. Still, 1 in 6 children will encounter a problem to read during their first 3 years in school. To cope with their disabilities, people use techniques such as using graph paper for math, making an outline of a lecture to remember it, using sticky notes, and being taught by a tutor. All of these solutions, in addition to many more, could be a normal thing for people who have learning disabilities. Remember a time when you overheard someone labeling you. How did this make you feel? Sad, annoyed, angry. Now remember a time when your label made other people think less of you, such as if you were labeled dumb. This can make you feel worthless or useless. This is exactly what happens every day if you have a learning disability. This usually happens as foul jokes. Only recently have I had a wake-up call that explained why some of those foul jokes happen. A little while back, I told my friend I have dyslexia. Her first response was, "How do you read at all, and how do you spell?" This brought some new thought and emotion on me. Maybe you had this emotion. It was anger, along with the thought of, is this how you see me now? Because of this one little thing, this one little word. The next thought I had was, I know how to read fine because I do it a lot to do it well. As for spelling, I might get long, multi-syllable words wrong, but I can still spell. I'm not illiterate. This could have been directed to anybody with a learning disability. What did you do if you heard someone say this to you, or something equivalent to this, like label you? Do you just forgive them or forget? After this event, I realized most people assume the worst with people who have learning disabilities. In fact, 67% of young students identify as being at risk for reading disabilities were able to achieve average or above average reading ability when they received help early. Here's the truth. Don't assume because of a phrase, word, or sentence that this defines a person. What I've learned from having ADHD and dyslexia is that don't ever give up. We can all make the world a better place if you don't judge people. And just because a person has a learning disability, don't count them out just yet. Now, a word can seem like it defines someone in a way. But if you dig a little deeper, you can find the word doesn't mean that. And the word can mean so many more things than what you thought it meant.